Today, are you an early bird or a night owl? Our activity patterns and sleep cycles could influence our risk of diseases, such as type 2 diabetes and heart disease. If the world's ant population were to be distributed, each person in the world could get 2.5 million of them. And part 1 of NASA's DART mission was really a success. Smacked asteroid looks like a comet with a long tail of debris and dust. Hello there, my name is Michael and you're watching MW Newscast with interesting news from around the world. These are the details for today's stories. First story, night owls have greater risk of type 2 diabetes and heart disease. Some of us leap out of bed eager to get on with the activities of the day. For others, emerging from under the bed covers is so difficult and left until the last possible minute, often because of having been awake until the small hours. We have developed our sleep and activity patterns to become either an early bird or a night owl. Technically, this is called chronotype, which describes what time of the day we prefer to sleep or at what time we are most alert and energetic. A recent study by researchers from the Rutgers University in New Jersey suggests that a chronotype may have implications in our health. Our sleep-wake cycles are associated with our body's metabolism. According to the study, early birds rely more on fat as an energy source, are more sensitive to insulin levels, and burn more fat at rest and during exercise. On the other hand, night owls may be more prone to heart disease and type 2 diabetes than early birds because the bodies are less able to burn fat for energy. Hence, fat builds up more easily. The study also found that early birds are more physically active and have higher fitness levels than night owls, who are more sedentary throughout the day. Time to review and adjust our chronotypes. Next story, we only knew there were so many, but the ant population is really huge, almost unimaginable. Ants can be found in nearly all habitats, except for polar regions. While sometimes they can be a nuisance when they invade your kitchen or ruin your picnic, they are usually important in the ecosystems where they live. They help with nutrient cycling, aerate soil, disperse it, and decompose biomatter from plants and cadavers. Have you ever wondered how many ants are crawling around on Earth? Well, scientists from the Insect Biodiversity and Biogeography Laboratory of the School of Biological Sciences, SBS, at the University of Hong Kong, HKU, have addressed the seemingly impossible question and revealed a mind-boggling conclusion. There are 20 quadrillion ants on the planet in full numbers, that's 20 followed by 15 zeros. The team of researchers analyzed 489 studies that gathered data on ground and tree-dwelling ants in different habitats across all continents to come up with a mind-blowing estimate. There are about 12,000 known species of ants, or 16,000 if you break down all their subspecies. The total mass of ants on Earth weighs in about 12 megatons of dry carbon, a standard way of measuring animals' biomass. Next time you have the urge to squash one, reconsider it, they have an important role in the ecosystem. Last story for today, asteroid smacked by NASA spacecraft last week now looks like a comet with a very long tail. Part 1 of NASA's Doppler Asteroid Redirection Test, DART mission was a success. More images and details kept coming in about the asteroid intentionally smashed by the spacecraft last week. If you watched the crash live, the end of the video was a dark screen, just like when you lose signal. But Hubble and the Webb's telescopes captured the instant of the impact, and NASA just released the stunning images. But this latest image by a telescope in Chile, called Sooo, has captured the asteroid Dimorphos few days after the impact by DART, and found the asteroid is trailing a stream of debris, more than 10,000 kilometers, 6,000 miles long. Scientists expect the comet-like tail to get even longer and disperse even more, becoming so tenuous at one point that it's undetectable. Eventually, it will be like any other dust floating around the solar system. scientists continue observing the aftermath of the impact to see if the asteroid's path changed as it was planned. Part 2 of the mission, I will keep you informed. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching MW Newscast. Hit the like button and share the news with your friends and contacts. And subscribe to my channel. Once again, my name is Michael. Take care of yourself and have a great day.